Hey there. Shh, be extra quiet. I noticed this beautiful bird in the park this morning, and I've been watching it for a few hours. As I've watched it, I've noticed so many unique things.
Oh, hey Mia. What's this?
You want me to write down what I noticed about the bird? Why would I write that in my science notebook? Don't be silly, Mia. This isn't science. I'm just having fun. Are you sure? I think we need to find out, what is science? Let's get started. When you think of the word science, what comes to mind? I think of the doctors who help me when I'm sick, or even paleontologists who study ancient fossils. There are so many different kinds of scientists out there, but they all study very different things. So, what exactly is science? Science is the study of the natural world around us. The natural world is everything outside that grows, lives, or exists in nature. Let's look at an example. Study this picture closely. When you are ready, take out your guided notes and draw a picture of all the things you see in this picture that you think are part of the natural world. Remember, it has to grow, live, or exist in nature to be a part of the natural world. While you work, pause the video by clicking the button that looks like this. When you're done, start the video again. Let's see if we notice the same things. I see grass, trees, clouds, blue sky, and humans. Good noticing. Everything in this picture is part of the natural world. The clouds, the trees, the grass, blue sky, and the people are all part of the natural world because they grow, live, or exist in nature. That means you are a part of the natural world too. So anytime you notice and ask questions about the natural world around you, you are acting like a scientist. Mia was right. That means I am practicing science by paying attention to, or observing, the bird in the park. In that case, let's take out our guided notes and review what I noticed about the bird this morning. The bird leaves the nest often, the bird is chirping and singing, and the bird has a nest up high in a tree. To make sure we have notes about what this bird looks like, let's draw a picture. Pause the video here and draw a picture of the bird to add to our notes. We have learned a lot about this bird just by observing it. But now that we have all of this information, I have so many questions. Why is the bird leaving the nest so much? When the bird is chirping, is it talking to other birds? Why is the nest so high in the tree? Asking questions is a super important part of science. Every time you ask a question, you are one step closer to learning something new. Now that we have some scientific questions ready, how do we find the answers? We have to investigate, or look closely and ask questions, to learn more about the bird. Let's give it a try. Let's focus on one of my questions at a time. Why is the bird leaving the nest so much? I think I'm going to need a tool to get a closer look. Ooh, yeah, that's better. There it is! Oh my goodness, where is it going? I lost it! Hold on. Okay, there it is. It looks like it flew over to this sunflower and it... Look at that! The bird is eating sunflower seeds! That must mean the bird has to be leaving the nest to find food to eat. Pause the video here so we can write down what we have learned in our guided notes. Wow. By observing and investigating the bird, we were able to answer one of my questions. The bird was leaving the nest to find food. It turns out science is just paying attention to and asking questions about the world around us. I guess that makes me a scientist. And you too! As you're going about your day, start noticing and asking questions about the world around you. Why is the sky blue? How do birds fly? Where do rainbows come from? There are so many scientific wonders out there just waiting to be discovered. Thanks for your help today, scientist. Remember, science is all around you. Hey.